This episode brought to you by Virtual Shield VPN. With the authoritarian left cracking down on free speech, there's never been a better time to use a VPN. Their suggestions that our credit scores might be based on our internet history in the near future. The same way that banks use data like income to judge credit eligibility now is how websites could use internet search history in the near future. I will not let my internet history be the judge of my credit score. That's why I use Virtual Shield. Just go to the link in the description and pin comment and get Virtual Shield for 50% off today.
Blue lives matter, huh? Law and order. Law and order. Blue lives matter. Respect the flags. Respect law enforcement. Why don't you just comply? Don't you dare even say that again.
What gives this guy any kind of moral high ground to lecture anybody about respect for police officers? I think the main takeaway here from Don Lemon is that he wants you to shut up. I mean, it's been pretty obvious for a long time that that's what he wants you to do, but clearly he's feeling emboldened to just come right out and say it. If you agree, hit that like button, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you can be notified about new content. I get it. It's nauseating to sit here and watch this powerful state propagandist play the victim and then lecture about respect for police officers after he and his cohorts have egged on anti-police riots for the last 8 months that targeted officers and their precincts, leading to thousands of officers injured and a 28% surge in police ambush killings. And remember, back during Obama's administration, when ambushing police was a thing, with one of the worst attacks happening at a BLM rally where they were calling for violence. But of course, the media did their best to separate BLM and by extension themselves from the violence. Lemon says here that we have to stop saying "why don't you comply" as an argument. Obviously, because it's an obvious question that any sane, rational person would ask, and that he has no response for. All of that because a tiny minority of violent people fought with riot police? Fighting with riot police is like the bread and butter of the left. They don't have rallies without fighting riot police. But the media never shows you video like this. But obviously, that's not how any of this works. They control all the flow of information. But it just goes to show how much power and how nefarious characters like Lemon are. They really see themselves as a kind of Orwellian information ministry. And like I said earlier, fighting riot police is like the bread and butter of the left. They've been doing it pretty hardcore for the last few years in cities like Portland, but it's been a staple going back decades. Just go back and look at the inauguration of George W. Bush and all the Democrats that were fighting police.
You're defending a fascist, exploitative state.
What do you think that Lemon and his fellow lapdogs are telling themselves? It's different when they do it because their reasons are more valid than yours. Even though networks like CNN helped to spread conspiracy theories like hands up, don't shoot, which led to death and destruction, including those Dallas police officers that I mentioned earlier. Will they ever be held to the same standards they're attempting to hold 75 million Americans to? Of course not.
Die. If they had gotten Pelosi, God forbid, if they had gotten Schiff, if they had gotten Pence, God forbid, would you vote to convict them?
No.
Who did they have to get?
No.
And I would be pointing, how about her? How about him? Would this have done it for you? You guys eat lunch a lot together. What if he died?
Yeah.
Where was all this rhetoric from Chris Cuomo, Don Lemon, and the rest of the media when heated rhetoric from the Democrats about health care led to an actual attack on Republicans that almost assassinated half the GOP Senate? It was nowhere to be seen. And as I pointed out in the past, CNN actually badgered one of the victims about toning down the rhetoric.
Do you think that the press is the greatest enemy of the U.S.? Sure, but the greatest enemy. Would you call us? Would you ever call CNN an enemy?
No.
Tweeted out that especially NBC and CNN. Just let me just say it one second. I won't read the whole thing because I remember last year after the tragedy there on the baseball diamond, we talked about how we were all going to make an effort to come together and show more unity and build bridges.
At the time, Bernie Sanders scoffed that violence coming from his supporters, of which there was a lot at the time, had anything to do with Bernie Sanders.
Some of your supporters in Chicago were acting violently as well. And I have to say, the guy who rushed the stage yesterday at Donald Trump voted for you. Now, I know you're not encouraging the violence, but
Jake,
you need to tell your supporters.
Millions of people voted for me. If I have to take responsibility for everybody who voted for me, it will be a very difficult life.
The rhetoric then, Senator, because if you're going to sit down with people on both sides of the aisle, some Democrats have branded Republicans the party of death, for example, calling the tax cuts in the Senate health care bill blood money. You yourself have said Republicans are potentially killing Americans. Is that rhetoric irresponsible, and does it provide an impasse to compromise? If you're going to sit down with very people that you've now said want to kill people.
No, I never said. That's not, you're using rhetoric that I didn't use.
Oh, am
okay?
I? These
when
are
I
quotes.
Said, oh, no,
party
no, no,
of
no.
death is
Let
a quote.
You're not going to get away with this travesty. You're not going to cause enormous pain and death for people all over this country.
Comes to mind, the idea of otherizing people is something I think we saw a lot of over the last 4 years. I mean, it's something we've seen a lot over the last decades, but it's so easy to otherize people, to make people other than American, other than patriotic, other than human.
Gee, I don't know, maybe like calling half the country racist, white supremacists, and literal Nazis? I mean, this is just completely insane. CNN spends every night otherizing half the country.
You know, and we've seen it in Bosnia, we've seen it in Rwanda, where radio was telling people, the you know, Hutus were telling the radio listeners that Tutsi were cockroaches, for, you know, getting them ginned up for genocide. And you see it in these videos where people who claim they are patriots are in the face of a police officer calling him, you know, as we're seeing it right there.
I'm sorry, what? Did Anderson Cooper seriously just compare a guy cursing at a police officer to what happened in Bosnia and in Rwanda? 8,000 men were massacred in Bosnia in a war that killed over 100,000 people. In Rwanda, more than 800,000 moderate Hutus and Tutsis were killed over a 3-month period. Cooper's comparison here is just baffling to me. It makes me wonder what his end goal is. Combined with the coverage that we've seen over the last few weeks, it's clear to me that they want the country to think that the other half are essentially comprised of horrible racist monsters, basically just Nazis. Now comparing a mostly peaceful protest to some of the most horrible atrocities in our lifetimes. I also find it both hilarious and maddening at the same time that these two can sit there opining about their political enemies otherizing people while they themselves are sitting there doing that as they speak. No doubt telling themselves that it's different when they do it. So that tells you who this guy works for and why nothing they say is trustworthy. If you want to support this channel and help me to continue exposing these hacks, you can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. That's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.